Hi guys, welcome back for another movie recap. Today, I'm going to give you an overview of the 2017 Australian-French psychological thriller horror film called Berlin Syndrome. The story follows a young Australian photographer who visits Germany and meets a handsome young English teacher. Waking up one morning, after a wild night of passion with him, the photographer discovers something truly horrifying. Warning: there will be spoilers ahead, so please proceed with caution. Claire arrives in Berlin, Germany, as a young female tourist in the beginning of the film. She walks to her lodging, a hostel with group bunking rooms, and spends the evening on the rooftop with a group of other travelers. After taking photographs of the dawn, she gets dressed and goes sightseeing with her backpack in the morning. While exploring her new environment, she decides to buy some clothes, photo slides, and takes photos of things she sees in the street, including one of a woman airing a colorful sheet out an apartment window. Claire goes to a bookstore and is drawn to a book of artworks. She follows a man out of the shop and they meet on the sidewalk near a set of traffic lights. He drops his belongings and Claire helps him, sparking a conversation, in which he casually inquires as to why she is traveling alone and offers her strawberries. Claire learns that the man's name is Andy, and they visit the public garden where the wild strawberries grow. They converse and get to know one another, with Andy remarking that it's an excellent location to complicate life, which Claire corrects to contemplate life. Claire receives a call from her mother, but decides not to answer it. Andy drives her back to her lodging, and they almost kiss. He declines her invitation to join her in the bar for a drink. The next day, Claire goes exploring again, this time looking for Andy, who she discovers in the same bookshop, browsing at an art book. They spend the entire day together. He drives them back to his house, which is forlorn and quiet. His upper flat is hidden behind a gated building entrance, via a tiny enclosed courtyard, and into the building block beyond it. They spend the night together, and she expresses her desire to stay rather than continue on to her next destination, Dusseldorf. He goes to work as a teacher at a local school in the morning. Franca, one of the students, describes a book that the class was required to read. Claire gets ready, packs a day bag, and heads out the door only to discover she is locked inside. She can't find a spare key, and the windows aren't working. She stays in the flat, makes herself some dinner, and waits for Andy to arrive, believing this is an accident. When he gets home, Claire explains that she is unable to go, and he realizes that he failed to leave her a key, which he discovers in his pocket. "Did you lock me in?" she jokes, to which he responds, "Yeah, but next time I'll tie you to the bed," and they have sex in the shower. They go out clubbing, and she decides to spend another night. When he departs for work in the morning, he points out the key he left for her on the dresser. While cooking herself breakfast, she casually pokes around the apartment and discovers the book of artworks from the bookstore. When she opens it to her favorite page, she sees a snapshot of herself sleeping with the word "mind" scribbled on her shoulder laying among the pages. Her mother had given her the ring to hawk and return home if she gets into trouble, but it also had sentimental value. She panics when she investigates the apartment and discovers that the key won't unlock the door. Her phone is dead, the other internal door is also locked, and none of the available windows open. She tries to break the glass with a chair, but she discovers a second, reinforced panel behind it. Claire is waiting for Andy at the door when he returns, and she requests to go, but he refuses. He locks the door and confronts her about the shattered window, casually stating that if she attempts to break it, he will have to boarder them up. She begs him to let her go now that she realizes the gravity of the situation, but he dismisses her pleas and hands her flowers while asking if she enjoys pasta. She erupts in wrath, attempting to kick and beat him, but he subdues her and ties her to the bed, stating that no one can hear her shouts because the buildings have been abandoned. Her screams are not heard from the street, as the camera pans out. Andy meets his father the next day, who inquires as to why he was late. Andy claims to have met someone and informs him of Claire's situation. Andy tells his father that Natalie, the girl he's been dating, has returned to Canada. Andy returns to the flat, where he has continued to use a plastic sheet to bind Claire to the bed. She's untied for a shower after peeing on herself, and she notices clumps of long blonde hair in the drain, implying that someone else was here before her. He brings her a puzzle and informs her that he has told his father about her and texted her mother that she is fine. Claire threatens to tell his mother the truth. He refused to acknowledge her. Andy leaves for work the next day, leaving Claire untethered and free to roam the flat because she is unable to flee. We observe him place the keys in a lockbox and place it on a shelf in the corridor of the building. Claire looks around the flat and discovers a screwdriver hidden beneath the couch. Andy gets irritated at work by a teacher who uses his cup from the shared kitchen, which the lady empties and washes away. He returns home to discover Claire working on the puzzle. He assists her, and she takes advantage of the situation by stabbing the screwdriver through his hand laying on the tabletop, pinning him to the table. She grabs the keys and flees down the stairway and across the courtyard, but Andy catches her and crushes her hand in the front door, shattering her finger. He returns to the apartment with a passed-out Claire. He meets his father the next day. Claire tries to restore peace to the tense atmosphere when he arrives home. She continues to pleading with him, telling him how much she misses her mother, but Andy reminds her that it's pointless to miss something you won't get back, and that she has him instead. Andy is continually photographing Claire in strange and disturbing situations, generally naked. The next day, Andy notices Franca, a female student, aroused in gym class. Meanwhile, Claire uses a paperclip to pick the door locks, snapping one in the internal door, and is concerned that Andy may notice. Andy has locked all of the sharp instruments in the lockbox with the key, as we can see. He continues to mentally and emotionally torment and frighten Claire, alternating between tenderness, possessiveness, and harshness. Sometime later, Franca comes to Andy's apartment. She knocks on the door, while Andy is in the shower bathing Claire. Andy threatens Claire, threatening to kill her if she says anything. Franca flirts with Andy as he opens the door, claiming that she followed him home. Franca sees Claire, who is standing in a towel in the hallway. Andy informs her that Claire is his girlfriend. After this, he becomes mean to Franca, prompting her to depart. Claire inquires about the girl, asking her name, while Andy trims her hair, photographing her once more. Later, Andy becomes irritated with Claire when he realizes the interior door won't open. We notice that time has passed, and it is now Christmas. Life has not gotten better for Claire. She is living in fear, but as Andy continues to toy with her, she begins to unravel and act out. At one point, Andy asks her to be normal, and in his annoyance at her behavior, he becomes violent, leaving to stay with his father. The electricity goes out in Andy's flat, and Claire is left without power for days. It's brutally cold, and she consumes whatever food she can find. Andy's father dies, and he stays in his father's house for a few days before calling the caretaker. Claire discovers another girl's toenail cuttings under the bed. When Andy returns to the flat a few days later, Claire is relieved. Andy had been uninformed of the power outage and informs him that she didn't think he was coming back. They make love while she consoles him on his father's death. Claire adjusts to the circumstance by cleaning, cooking, putting effort into her appearance, and listening to music. For Christmas, Andy gifts her a book and his father's dog. Claire inquires as to why he chose her, and he says that he saw her on the street, staring at the woman airing the sheet next to the window, revealing that he had organized their meeting in the bookshop. When Claire inquires about the woman who was in the apartment previously, we notice a rapid shift in his feelings for her, as he becomes agitated by her queries. He takes her out of the apartment and into a remote wilderness sometime later. He is wielding an axe. While Claire enjoys finally being outside, he raises his axe behind her. However, a small child shouts and runs over, interrupting the conversation, screaming for assistance for his injured brother. Andy is distracted by their presence, so Claire takes advantage of the opportunity to try to inform the other boy, but he doesn't speak English and is scared by her hurry. Andy observes Claire and becomes enraged. When Claire's mother returns with her children, Andy drags her back to the car and shoves her into the boot before driving back to the flat. Andy, irritated by Claire's presence and envious of her relationship with the dog, takes the dog for a walk and fails to return with it, claiming it ran away. Claire is heartbroken and alone once more. Claire slips into the locked room while Andy is at a New Year's Eve party, finding his camera, a massage chair, and a photo book of Claire in captivity. Claire also discovers an album of a blonde girl who has been chained and mistreated in the same way as Claire. Andy tries to entice another young female traveler by starting a discussion and utilizing the same blunder he made with Claire, mistaking contemplate life for compensate life, but the girl leaves with her friend. Back in the kitchen, Claire spots a torchlight shining from another apartment across the courtyard. She screams and smashes the mended window pane to alert the person to her distress. A man nearly frees Claire by reaching the apartment door, but Andy reappears and kills him with a hammer. Andy insults Claire, accusing her of being to blame for the man's death, and forces her to assist him in wrapping up the body, which he then burns in the courtyard's coal pit. The next day, Andy cleans up the blood and boards up the windows. He sees Claire's picture in a missing people ad in the local paper and, panicked, tells her to pack her belongings because he is fumigating the apartment. Claire notices some student workbooks on the table. She burns her hand on purpose, and when Andy goes to the toilet to get some cream, she takes Franca's workbook. Andy clears away all of the drinks the next morning, and departs with his and Claire's belongings, leaving Claire behind in the flat. He stows Claire's suitcase in the basement and shuts off the water, leaving Claire without running water. When he hands out the workbooks at school, Franca notices a tied and gagged photo of Claire slid between the pages. Franca quickly excuses herself from the school and escapes on her bike without calling notice to her finding. Other students discover the photo on the floor, and Andy rushes back to her apartment, becoming stopped in traffic. Andy discovers Franca's bike outside the front door and discovers that she has snuck into the basement through a basement window. He finds the hammer and lock box in the courtyard, as well as an open window in the building block. Claire appears to have left the apartment through the open door. We watch him following muddy footsteps up the stairway, passing Claire cowering in a stairwell cupboard. Claire calls from downstairs, drawing him back inside the apartment, just as he reaches the room where Franca is hiding. Claire manages to slip out and lock the flat door after he is distracted inside. Andy is now locked inside. Claire experiences a feeling of euphoria as she realizes she is finally free of the flat and Andy. Claire yells in triumph, chucking the keys against the outside of the door, tormenting Andy, as he begs her to let him out of the apartment. She collects Franca, and discovers a bag containing her passport and mother's ring. The final scenes of the movie show Andy relaxing in his massage chair, while Claire enjoys her freedom by driving through Berlin, passing tourists on their way to view the attractions. If you like this movie, make sure to smash the like button. Want to see more great videos? Hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day ahead and I'll see you next time.